Now we're cooking with Mary Mammoliti.
Today, I'm going to be making the flaky. You know those Vachon cakes? What I'm doing is I'm making a copycat version of that. So let's get started. We're going to preheat our oven to 400 degrees. We're going to start with preparing our puff pastry. So all I did was I purchased two sheets. They usually come in one box. Two sheets come in one box of 12-inch puff pastry. I removed my puff pastry and I put it into lined room baking sheet with parchment paper. And then I placed the puff pastry directly on top of that. We're gonna do a little bit of an egg wash on top. So I've got myself one egg and I've added in here about a tablespoon of water. With a fork in a bowl, I want you to mix this up until it's all combined. And then using a pastry brush, we're gonna lightly brush the tops of this first sheet of puff pastry. Now you want just a light coating of it. We don't want to get it too moist. Next step is we're going to take our second sheet of puff pastry and we're going to lay it directly on top of this first one. Line it up as best as I can and then lay it over top. You can manipulate and stretch and move the puff pastry to wherever you need it to go. Now that we've got both sheets of puff pastry, one on top of the other, with a layer of the egg wash in between, we're gonna actually place this tray in the freezer for about 10 to 15 minutes. It'll make it easier for us to cut it into squares. While our pastry dough is chilling, we're gonna get our raspberry compote ready. So here I've got my cooktop, I've got a pot filled in here. I've already put my fresh raspberries in here, about 2 cups. You can use frozen if you have it.
I also add a couple of blueberries and blackberries for depth of flavor, but it's not necessary for the recipe. I then add 1/2 cup of white sugar, stir it in, turn the heat on medium, and we're gonna reduce this.
All right, and we've now removed our pastry from the freezer. I've got the raspberry compote down to a consistency that I am extremely happy with. So we've cooked this down to about 10 minutes, and then we added in our cornstarch slurry, which was 1/4 cup of water and 2 teaspoons of cornstarch. Mix that up in a bowl and then pour it into the pot with the raspberries. Cook that down for another 1 minute or so, and then let it cool to room temperature. Let's move on to our pastry. We're gonna cut this now into 4-inch squares. So I'll put my hand to the end of the pastry and then gently touch the side of my thumb with the knife, and that's how I know that's my 4. And now I'm just cutting along the pastry and turning them into squares. Perfect. I'm just gonna separate the squares. Just give them a little room in between. You don't want them to stick together when you put them in the oven. Don't worry if they're not perfect. Nothing in life is perfect. Another little light brush of egg wash. Again, a light brush, that's all we want. And now we're gonna sprinkle some sugar over top. Now I'm a little generous, but you put as little or as much as you like on top. Done. Okay, I'm gonna pop this now into the oven for 15 to 20 minutes. We're gonna get our cream ready. So I've got in here, I've got the bowl of my stand mixer. I've already placed in here the icing sugar. I'm gonna add in 1/3 cup of room temperature butter, 2 to 3 tablespoons of milk. Add that in. We're gonna place it back on to my stand mixer and we're gonna get that going and get this all nice and creamy. We're gonna put this on low to begin. Give it a couple of seconds, and then once you feel like everything's been incorporated, put up the speed a little bit to about maybe medium. Okay, so we're gonna let this go on its own until it gets nice and creamy. And let's scoop this into our bowl. I think anyone will judge me if I just take a spoon and eat that right out of here. So I took this time to clean up a little bit and get ready to get the puff pastry out of the oven. Oh, there it is.
Fresh out of the oven, and these smell great. Using a knife, I split open the pastry through the middle like a hamburger bun.
I'm gonna take 1 tablespoon of the buttercream, placing it right on the bottom half, and I'm using the back of the spoon just to spread it out slightly. There we go. And we're gonna take 1 tablespoon of the raspberry compote, put that right over top of your buttercream. Now we're cooking. Place the other half right on top and dig in.
It's flaky, it's light, it's definitely messy, but so worth it.
I hope you guys enjoy this recipe as much as I do. Thanks for watching and bon appetit.